Hello, my name is Jagmohan Chawla and I'm the Product Manager for Project and Task Management in SAP Cloud ALM. In this video, we are going to see how you can set up a project using Agile methodology in SAP Cloud ALM. We'll see how a project lead can set up a project, look at the phases that come from SAP Activate, give them some dates, and then create a sprint schedule which is preferably aligned to those phase dates. You can also see how you can create user stories, assign story points to the user stories, which basically give you a relative sizing and quick estimation. And then you can assign these stories to a sprint schedule. So let's get started. As you can see, I'm in the overview page and I can click on the manage project to reach my project setup. I can click on the time box tab and start editing my timelines. I've already created my phase, which basically follow a monthly schedule. In this case, I want to align my sprints to my realize phase. And the first sprint is already created. Let's create a new sprint. I can give it any name and then give a date range. Then I can save my assignments and get to my task list to start creating my user stories. To create a user story, you can just click on the create and select the option for user story. You can see the attributes of the user story are very similar to the task. Now I can give a title to the user story and enter a brief description. I can also assign story points to my user story. And now note carefully that we do not offer a linear scale, but we offer a modified Fibonacci sequence. The idea is to get to relative size quickly and not do a lot of effort in precise effort estimation. In this case, let's give this user story 3 points. Now I want to assign this user story to a sprint. To do that, I can click on the time box. I can look at the sprint which I just created, and let's see, I want to assign this to sprint 2. Note my sprint 2 ends on July 30. Let me save the user story. You can see now that the due date of the user story is automatically set to the due date of the sprint. I can create a subtask if I want to additionally detail out my user story. Now let's close this and get back to task list. Let's see if we can find the user story that we created easily by searching for the sprint. And that's exactly what happened. As you can see, you search for user stories for sprint 2, but in order not to repeat the same activity, you can create a custom view for a sprint, give it the name of your choice and save it. If you want, you can even set it as default. Thank you for watching this video. You now know how to set up a project, create a phase schedule, create a sprint schedule, create user stories, assign story points to user stories, and assign user stories to sprints. We recommend that you watch the video, How to Define the Process Scope in SAP Cloud ALM.